All right, we need to talk about these new Canva updates because they're complete game changers. If you're a content creator or a business owner, these new Canva features will blow your mind, speed up your workflow, and transform the way you design. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people. It's Natalia, and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. I'm always so excited to be back with another Canva tutorial slash Canva tips and tricks video, but this one is on another level. I'm here to help you discover some of the most recent exciting updates that you can use today to make your designs more engaging faster than ever. As it's only been a week since these were launched, chances are you haven't even heard of them yet. If I helped you to find a tip that you liked, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more videos. But in the meantime, let's jump to update number one, create an animation. This feature has got to be my favorite out of the bunch. We now have the power to create our own custom animations, and it's a complete game changer for all of us who don't really know how to animate in After Effects. Now, all you need to do is to select an element, and by the way, it works with text, with photos, and with videos too. Then we need to go up here to animate, click that, and from here, from that top panel in here, we need to select create an animation. Now from here, we're going to drag our element to create a path for the animation, just like that. And here it is. You can just release whenever you're ready, and it's really as simple as that. But then from the slider in here, you can just adjust the speed. So if you want the feather to go a little bit faster, you can do that too. And if you're not happy with your animation, just click delete path here at the bottom and start over. You can then also start animating, but you can also hold shift while animating to create straight lines. When you're ready, you can hit done and enjoy your completely custom animation. And it's, to be honest, it's completely mind-blowing for me. It's also worth noting that it's available for all users, so the free plan gets access to create an animation, so it's absolutely incredible. By the way, I have a full video all about Canva animations coming out next week, so make sure you're subscribed and hit that notification bell to not miss it. Okay, now we've got plenty more to get through, so let's go to update number two, Magic Design. This one is so useful, especially if you're not feeling particularly inspired or don't want to start from scratch. And with sheer amounts of templates available in the Canva library, it's not always easy to find the right one that's fit for purpose, but that's where Magic Design comes in. Let's go to the templates tab from the homepage right here to see what this function can do. Now, as you can see, we have the suggestion to try Magic Design, so I'm going to just do that and click this button right here. And as you can see, we have this new box pop up in here to actually let us insert our own media, so provide Canva with the image that we want to use. If I click on it, I can choose the file to upload from my computer, or I can just select some of the ones that I've uploaded previously. So I'm going to just choose that image right here. And as you can see, Canva whips up all the different suggestions for the design that I want. As you can see, it sees kind of the vibe of the image, analyzes it. So in here, it suggested an online course, but I might not want to create something that has to do with an online course. I can just go to the headline right here. And from here, I'm just going to say new Canva updates. From here, I can just add it to the results and see what it looks like on those templates. Now, I'm pretty fond of these, but let's say I want to change the style of the design that it's suggesting me. So from here, I can add a theme or a vibe. So I'm going to go for a minimalist. Let's say maybe something to do with marketing in here, for example. I think I'm going to be fine with this. And let's choose a style. So these are our palettes or the different fonts that it suggests. I'm quite fond of this one. So let's see what it can give me. Brilliant, I'm happy with this one. From here, I can then click on it and click customize this template. And that's going to give me this exact one that I can start working on. Now, one thing that I want to mention, so we're back in the Magic Design panel. Although it is free for all Canva users, you have to remember that it pulls suggestions from the whole Canva library, meaning that some of the templates will be free and some will be pro only. I think the one that I've chosen is actually pro only. I love Magic Design because it's really useful for those days when you're really stuck and want to introduce some freshness into your creative thinking. And now I couldn't see any kind of limitations or limitations counter anywhere for the Magic Design, but there's been some info circulating that it has a limit of 30 users in total for free users and 60 uses for pro monthly. I couldn't confirm it so far, but if I do, I'll make sure to leave it in the comments down below and in the description box as well. All right, let's continue in the same vein. We've got our third update, Magic Presentations and Magic Layouts. You probably know this feeling when you sit down to work on a presentation, you open up your tool and then you proceed to stare at a blank page for quite some time. Now, starting from scratch is obviously hard enough, but when you've got to organize the talking points for the presentation in a cohesive manner or represent them visually on a screen, it becomes a whole different story. Well, that's where another portion of Canva Magic comes in. With a simple AI prompt, you can now generate a whole presentation deck within seconds, and usually it's a pretty good first draft as well. So let's start with a brand presentation template from here, where we're in the editor right now. And in the left panel right here, you can see the first design tab right here. It's usually open at the very beginning, but from there, in the first tab, in the templates tab, you can see presentation magic. So Magic Design for presentations specifically. Let's click on it. And now Canva asks us to enter a prompt. You can try an example from here, but I'm going to have fun with it. So let's say I want a presentation on the impact of social media on body image and self-esteem. Okay, let's press enter, and after a moment, a box very similar to Magic Design pops up where you can choose the style you want to adopt for this subject. So you can keep clicking and preview all the different ones on the right hand side. I'm pretty fond of this particular one, so I'm going to choose it. As you can see, again, you've got the whole deck created in here. You can always start again to maybe tweak your prompt and then try to generate something a little bit different. But I'm going to go ahead and create my presentation from here. And here's our full deck, which, surprise, surprise, contains some really fun animations too. You could start working on it as is, but I want to show you another nifty little update that takes this whole thing to the next level. And that's our layouts panel right here at the very top. Now, Canva also has the power to suggest specific slide layouts for you based on the contents of your current slide. I'm happy with this one, but I think probably maybe these two could use some work because, you know, it could use a bit of an upgrade and they seem a little bit repetitive. So let's have a quick look. Okay, how about this one? Brilliant. Yes, I think I can definitely work with that. And of course, don't forget that there's also the styles tip, something that I've mentioned many times before, which you can use to quickly apply your vibe to the whole deck. So I could just use my color palette from my brand kit, keep kind of swapping it, keep seeing what it can generate. This one is a simple palette, so it's not going to actually do much. And I think it's quite a simple slide as well. You could go ahead and apply them to the whole presentation. And as you can see, all of the slides changed, but I was happy with the colors that gave me initially, so I'm going to just Control Z it, and I'm back to my deck. Okay, I finished working on my slide, and I can definitely say these features are definitely another great innovation for the presentation space within Canva. And the great news is as well is that it's available for free users too. And now while we're at it, let's move on to update number 4, Canva Assistant. When we were working on our presentation, you might have noticed this little cute icon here in the bottom right corner of the editor. And this is our new Canva Assistant, which is a seemingly small tool that has a really great power to help us transform our designs. So let's click on it, and voila, you can put even more magic into your work. Depending on what you've got selected or not selected, when you're simply in the editor like I am right now, you'll have different suggestions from Canva here. First of all, it instantly sees that we're in a presentation template, so it suggests Magic Design for presentations, but obviously we've just covered that. So let's then look at the second one here, and it's worth noting that what you know as Magic Write from Canva Docs has now been introduced across the board globally in all the different places around Canva. We can use this one to generate something new for us, like a list of tips, for example, or a paragraph talking about a specific point, but I want to show you the suggestions when you actually select an existing piece of text and then utilize the assistant. So let's select this one right here. And then now we have quite a few different cool options like summarizing or expanding, which is great for when you need a little bit more or a little bit less text for your designs. And you can then use rewrite to paraphrase and fix any mistakes and change up the tone a little bit as well. Super cool. And Magic Write is also available to anyone, but be very mindful that free users only get 25 uses of this tool in total. That's quite a limit, so definitely use it well. And for pro users, it's 75 uses per month, so you get plenty of chances to play with the tool and then make it work for you as well. And of course, if you'd like to try Canva Pro for free for 30 days, I have a link for you down in the description box, so go ahead and claim it now. All right, but Canva Assistant is not just about Magic Write. When you expand, you can see all the different suggested actions for you. So I can click on see more. You can see that I can align the text, do all the different things in here as well. And I can search for specific actions at the very top in here as well. I'm going to click away from that text to show you the different suggestions for the slide specifically. And when you scroll down, this bit right here is what I love most. Based on the existing design, Canva now suggests graphics and photos to match it, and it's so, so useful. Gone are the days of scrolling in the Elements tab to find similar photos to match the style. You can just use the assistant and see what you can find using Magic recommendations. For my social media presentation in here, it suggested some of the photos from the same photo shoot, which is so cool because it can create a more cohesive feel to the whole design, and there's definitely more to the assistant, so I encourage you to test it out on different elements or different designs and see what it can do for you. But in the meantime, let's jump to update number 5, translate. If you're multilingual or create content for international audiences, you're going to love this one. You can now translate whole designs with just a few clicks. To do this, go to apps here in the left panel and scroll down to find translate, or better yet, just pull up the assistant, of course, and search for it here. So I'm just going to say translate, and it's going to start the translation for me. In here, you can choose languages that you want to translate from. So in here, you can see that it's automatically detected, but I'm just going to say English, and the language that I want to translate to is Polish because that's my native language. So I'm going to choose that. And from here, you can apply it to the specific page that you want the translation for. That's just one page for this design. So that's me sorted in here. Also, I want you to take a quick look at the settings here at the top. So you can now choose to reduce a font size to fit the design if the translation is longer than what you had there initially. And you can choose to duplicate the page when translating so you can keep the original intact as well. Okay, let's go back in here to translate, hit translate, of course, and here is our translation ready within seconds. Also, again, as a native Polish speaker, I can definitely say that the translations are really good, so no complaints here from me on that front. This option is also available, but heavily limited on the free plan. It's currently giving you only 50 free uses in total. With Pro, as you can see, we've got 500 and they refresh every month. Okay, we're moving fast. We're now at update number 6, improved text to image. Text to image also got an upgrade, and we can now generate images in more styles and more ratios as well. So just as a recap, to access it, you can go to apps, and from the top, you can see the first suggestion as text to image as well. So just click on that. And as you can see, we have all the different new styles in here, and we can also generate square, landscape, and portrait images as well. Okay, from here, I want to try to generate a minimalistic pattern with small blue blue outline leaves. I want to use it maybe as a little backdrop for one of my designs. I might want to kind of overlay it and maybe change the transparency as well. And I want to choose the watercolor option, basic like that. So let's generate a square because that's actually the design that I'm in. And from here, we've got four different examples. You can always kind of go back, tweak your prompt, choose a different style. Let's say this is something that I would be happy with for this particular design. I could always kind of go back on the transparency and have an overlay of text in here, but maybe this is not something that I'm after. So I can go in here and actually maybe choose a different style. Let's try 3D and let's create again. All right, these are definitely not leaves, but this is something that I could definitely use kind of either now or in the future if I'm starting from scratch on my particular design. And remember that if I click on it, it actually begins to upload within my uploads tab. So these images stay with you within your account, so you can always kind of reuse them later on as well. Hence why I've chosen to stick with this one. Hi guys, I'm just editing this video and I've realized this is getting way too long. I'm going to have to split it in two. So part two will be posted tomorrow. I'll link it up here for you so that it's easy to access. But in the meantime, if you can let me know down in the comments which one of these features has been your favorite so far. Thank you so much for watching and hopefully see you tomorrow.